The Inter-Party Advisory Council IPAC Ekiti State Chapter has demanded for the expenditure of funds allocated to all the 16 local government areas in the state. The body asked that all the local government chairmen in Ekiti need to explain to the public how they spent the huge amount received from the Federation account. In a statement signed by IPAC chairman and made available to journalists, it said it is high time the people of Ekiti knew where and what their monies have been spent on. A request which, according to the letter, is also to invoke the Freedom of Information Act. Joining us now is Ifedayo Iyaniwura, Ekiti State IPAC chairman. Thank you very much for joining us, sir.
Yeah, good evening.
Good evening to you.
Nice being with you here.
All right, please tell us more on the rationale behind the probe on local government allocation. Is it as a result of local council chairperson's outcry?
Well, if you could allow me to be more clear and devoid of ambiguity, let me start by saying that a letter dated 16th of June was written to the 16th Ekiti Local Government Council chairman, respectively, through DHL, demanding for the expenditure of funds allocated to each local government under the privilege of freedom of information. It is noteworthy to know that the 774 local government areas in Nigeria have been granted an autonomy. And the autonomy given to this local government is an executive order by Mr. President, President Muhammadu Buhari, that was last year, June. And it has come into force because the governors could not challenge it in court. It was never taken to court. It was never set aside. That shows it remains binding. And here in Ekiti State, we have 16 local government areas. And it may interest you to know that the present 16 elected local government chairmen in Ekiti State are first set of executive local government chairmen after an autonomy has been granted for this local government chairman, which is structure of government. Now, to the basis of this, our demand is the fact that, one, the local government chairman, a local government chairman has no immunity, and democracy produces an accountable government. In lieu to that, accountability, particularly in a democratic government, should be seen as a fundamental prerequisite for preventing the abuse of power and for ensuring that power is directed towards the achievement of efficiency, effectiveness, responsiveness, and transparency in the business of the government. This is the duty of the public and citizens to enforce it. And all that right. is exactly what we have embarked on in Ekiti State.
All right, how do you intend to use the Freedom of Information Act, considering how cumbersome it can be to unearth information when people don't want to reveal it?
Well, the Freedom of Information Bill is so clear and signed into law by the former President Goodluck Jonathan. That was 2011, and was passed across all cadres of government. And the provision in the Act has spelled it out that the notification should be served to this government of official who is in charge of that of financial divination. So, and within 7 days, they are expected to be respond, and if they fail to respond within that of 7 days, the law itself automatically activates itself. And they have a window period of 3 days to enjoy in addition to that of 7 days, at which the court shall take its course. And what did the court proclaim? The court says it is a jailable offense. That is a criminal offense for not responding at all. It's a jailable offense that attracts 1 year imprisonment plus 500,000 fine. And I want to believe that they will not want to try it, to risk it for being jailed while serving in office as a public official.
All right, let's stay optimistic on that score, and thank you very much for your time and the explanation given.
Thank you very much. You're welcome.